अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस वैगनर बीनबीन रीअरेंजमेंट। वैगनर बीनबीन वर टू साइंटिस्ट हु डिस्कवर्ड दिस रीअरेंजमेंट। व्हेन नियोपेंटाइल ब्रोमाइड इज आयनाइज्ड, ब्रोमीन विल बी रिमूव्ड। एज यू नो, ब्रोमीन बिलोंग्स टू द सेवन हैलोजन ग्रुप्स एंड कार्बन बिलोंग्स टू द फोर्थ ग्रुप। सो ब्रोमीन इज मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव, सो इट टेक्स अवे द बॉन्डेड पेयर विद इटसेल्फ एंड अपॉन आयनाइजेशन primary carbocation is formed. Primary carbocation, as you know, hyperconjugation rule, primary carbocation is less stable than secondary carbocation, and secondary carbocation is less stable than tertiary carbocation. So upon formation of primary carbocation, one of the alkyl group, methyl group, migrates from adjacent carbon to satisfy that positive charge. So primary carbocation will be converted into tertiary carbocation, and upon hydrolysis or upon the addition of water molecule will attach at carbon number 2 position instead of carbon number 1 position. That's why scientists, instead of discovering OH group at one position, instead they formed it at position number 2. So that position which actually should be formed neopentyl alcohol, that was not formed, and new structure will be formed at where alcohol is present at carbon number 2 instead of present as carbon number 1. First of all, the scientists when they examined that when new pentyl bromide is reacted with water, they thought that actual product formed should be but that product was not formed. They tried to figure it out why that wasn't happened, why another structure was formed. They examined the different steps of the Wagner-Bierwein rearrangement and of neopentyl bromide. In first step, they found that neopentyl bromide is ionized. So primary carbocation will be formed. As you know, primary carbocation is less stable according to the concept of hyperconjugation, and secondary carbocation is more stable than primary, and tertiary carbocation is more stable than tertiary as it contains more hyperconjugative structures. So that alkyl group from adjacent carbon is moved to that methylene group to satisfy that positive charge, and that positive charge will become on that carbon. So that is one carbocation, and that is tertiary carbocation. So as you know, according to hyperconjugation, tertiary carbocation is more stable, and upon hydrolysis or addition of water molecule, water will get attached to second carbon. So instead of formation of primary alcohol, tertiary alcohol will be formed because it is surrounded by three carbons, 1, 2, 3, and OH group will get attached at this position. So this is our tertiary alcohol. That neopentyl alcohol, when it is proton is added, that proton will get attached to that oxygen, and that oxygen will become oxonium ion, and ultimately that bond between CH2 and oxygen will be fragmented, and water molecule will be removed. So proton will be removed from the adjacent methyl group, and your new structure will be formed, that is alkene, that is called 2-methyl-2-butene, that is formed from your structure, that is called neopentyl alcohol. Neopentyl alcohol upon ionization proton hydroxyl group will be removed, that alkyl group will be migrated to that methylene group. So primary carbocation will be converted into tertiary carbocation. Tertiary carbocation on reaction with chlorine, it will form 2-chloro or tertiary chloro butane. And if you remove one of the proton from adjacent methylene group, your alkene will be formed, that is 2-methyl-2-butene. 1-bromopropene isomerizes quantitatively to 2-bromopropene under Friedel-Crafts condition. The 1-2 shift AB involved in this reaction again is an H atom shift. That is bromopropene 1, 2, 3, and that is catalyzed in the aluminium bromide and nitrobenzene. So bromine will be ionized, that is primary carbocation, and that positive charge will be migrated due to the migration of proton from adjacent methylene group, that is that proton will be migrated to this carbon. So primary carbocation, instead you will form secondary carbocation, and that is also called 1-2 shift. That is 1, that is 2 position, 1-2 shift. That proton will be removed to this carbon, primary carbon or first carbon from second position, that is why it is called 1-2 shift, and that structure is formed. And ultimately upon addition of bromine, your structure from 1-bromopropene 2-bromopropene will be formed, that is 1 carbon 2 carbon 3 carbon, that is 2-bromopropene, that is called 1-2 shift. Wegener-Meerwein rearrangement as a part of an isomerizing E1 elimination. When neocontyl alcohol in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, proton will get attached, water molecule will be removed, and primary carbocation will be formed. Primary carbocation will be formed, and that primary carbocation is converted into tertiary carbocation. The example of Wegener-Meerwein rearrangement as a part of an isomerizing E1 elimination, that neopentyl alcohol upon reaction with concentrated H2SO4 proton is added to that hydroxyl group, and that hydroxyl group will be removed as a water molecule. So a primary carbocation will be formed. As you know, primary carbocation is less stable, so from the adjacent carbon a methyl group will be transferred or migrated to this carbon, that is that alkyl group will be migrated to the primary carbocation. So a carbocation will be generated at this position, that is more stable carbocation, and upon removal of proton from this group, that double bond will be regenerated. So instead your new structure is formed, that is 2-methyl-2-butene. So we will derive the structure. The example of E1 elimination of neopentyl alcohol is that is CH3 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 CH2OH, that is called neopentyl alcohol upon E1 elimination. When it is reacted with concentrated H2SO4, proton will get attached to this hydroxyl group, and your new structure formed is CH3CH2HOH, and ultimately that bond will be fragmented, and new structure will be formed, that is primary carbocation, that is CH3, water molecule will be removed, CH3 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 CH2 plus, that is primary carbocation. As you know, according to conjugation, hyperconjugation, primary carbocation is less stable, so adjacent alkyl group will be migrated to this methylene group. Your next structure formed will be CH3 C positive CH3 CH2 CH3. and proton will be removed and that double bond will be generated and that proton will attach itself to the HSO4 to form H2SO4. So acid is working as a catalyst, so your new structure formed will be that is called 2-methyl-2-butene. Instead of formation of tertiary alcohol, 2-methyl-2-butene is formed. So upon E1 elimination, your new structure which is unsaturated due to the elimination of proton, 2-methyl-2-butene is formed. 2-methyl-2-butene is formed. When neopentylamine is reacted with nitrous acid, it reacts and nitrogen will be removed as nitrogen molecule. That nitrogen and that nitrogen both will combine to removed as nitrogen molecule, and there is formation of tertiary alcohol instead of formation of primary alcohol. There is a reason behind that. When you react neopentylamine with nitrous acid, diazotization will occur. That nitrogen and that nitrogen combined to be removed as nitrogen molecule and primary carbocation is formed. Upon migration of that alkyl group to the adjacent carbon, that methylene group, your primary carbocation is converted into tertiary carbocation, which on hydrolysis converted into tertiary alcohol instead of primary alcohol is formed. Tertiary alcohol is formed, and there is a certain reason when examiner will ask you why primary carbocation is formed and why primary alcohol is not formed, you will say that there is a condition that is called hyperconjugation, and hyperconjugation says that primary carbocation is less stable. Primary carbocation is less stable as compared to tertiary carbocation, so alkyl group from the adjacent carbon will migrate it towards the primary carbon and tertiary carbocation will be formed, and upon hydrolysis that OH group will get attached to this position, not this position. That's why when neopentylamine upon reaction with nitrous acid, it doesn't give simple primary alcohol, instead it gives tertiary alcohol due to the concept of hyperconjugation.